Chapter 11 is over current liabilities and payroll accounting, okay? Now, a lot of this is going to seem really familiar because we've talked about current assets a lot, okay? And this will seem familiar, especially when we get to short-term notes payable, because we just got done with talking about short-term notes receivable, didn't we? Okay. Okay, this is a way that they define liabilities, kind of a cute little way. This is something we owe right now in the present for something that happened in the past, and in the future we have to make some sort of sacrifice. Okay. So if I buy a television on credit, then I have an obligation right now because in the past I purchased that TV, and in the future I'm going to have to sacrifice and give them some cash, right? Now, let's focus on current long-term liabilities, and I mainly want to focus on the top part of these definitions, okay? Current liabilities are those that are expected to be paid within a year. Long-term liabilities or non-current liabilities are not expected to be paid within the next year, okay? That's pretty simple, isn't it? Is it due within the next 12 months? If it is, it's a current liability. If it's not, it's a long-term or non-current liability, okay? Now, there are a lot of liabilities that they're known or determinable. And what I mean by that is we know who we have to pay, we know how much we have to pay, we know when we have to pay, right? Included in these would be the things listed on this slide: accounts payable, sales tax payable, unearned revenues, payroll. Those are very specific as far as who we pay, how much we pay, when we pay, correct? Let's go through a few of those examples. Now, one thing, let's talk about sales tax payable. Some of you work retail, right? Who is it that worked retail? Remind me. Okay, Tiba, you work at Staples, right? You can come off the slide. So let's think about Staples. If you sell, let me think of an example here. Let's say you sell a $100 monitor to somebody, okay? And you ring them up at Staples. You know that you are going to collect more than $100 from that customer, right? You're going to collect the $100 for that sale, but if the sales tax rate is 8%, they're going to give you $8 as well. So you'll get $108 from that customer, right? Now, $8 of that dollars is not Staples, is it? Right. Whose is it?
The government.
It's the government's. Do you think that they are concerned about you paying that on a timely and accurate basis to them?
Yes.
Yes. So you act, or Staples acts, or any retail place acts as a collection agent for the government, don't they? And they need to make sure that they record a liability when they collect that sales tax. Let's look at the slide. On May 15, 17, Max Hardware sold building materials for $7,500 that are subject to a 6% sales tax. Well, what's the journal entry? Well, we booked the sale at $7,500, but we don't just receive cash at $7,500, do we? Because we're going to receive $450 additional dollars, which is the 6% times that sale amount. So we're going to actually receive, as the retailer, $7,950. But $450 of that is not ours, is it? Okay? $450 of that is not ours. And thus we have to set up a liability for that $450. And we have to pay that to the government. Does that make sense? And then, of course, when you eventually pay that, you're going to credit cash and debit the liability. Make sense? I mean, can you imagine? Imagine over the day after Thanksgiving, how much sales tax payable do you think somebody like Best Buy accrued? A lot. Oh, my goodness sakes. A lot, right? Okay. So as a retailer, you have to be very careful to accrue those liabilities and pay them on a timely basis. Let's talk about another concept real quick. Unearned revenues. Okay. Unearned revenues. Now, we've talked about unearned revenues before. Unearned revenues are when you receive money in advance, okay, of providing the product or service. Remember the revenue recognition principle? Revenue recognition principle states that we recognize revenue when it is earned. When is it earned? When you've provided the product or service. So if we receive $3,000 in advance on May the 1st to cater a wedding, then we debit cash and we credit unearned revenue, correct? Credit unearned revenue. And unearned revenue is a current liability, right? Now, when can we recognize that as revenue? When we provided the catering, okay? So in that case, we debit the unearned revenue and we can book it as revenue. We've satisfied that liability that we booked on May 1st once we provided that catering, and we can reduce the liability. Make sense?